Greetings. This is video number 10 in the series Comparing Christianity to Islam. Briefly to recap, I have already addressed the following areas. What does Christianity say about itself? What does Islam say about itself? What does Islam say about Christianity? Finally, let's get to the last of these four relationships. What does Christianity say about Islam? I'm not going to be politically correct, my friends. I am going to tell you the truth. The truth is a stumbling block for many. But if you listen to the truth and learn and know the truth shall set you free. Heavenly Father, right now I pray that you would guide my words, guide my tone, and let your love shine through to those who call themselves Muslim, to those who desire to submit to you. Open their ears to hear the truth, Lord. I bind the deaf and dumb rulers over them in Jesus' name. Open their hearts, Lord, to receive your word. So what does Christianity say about Mohammed's religion? Christianity does not specifically and directly address Islam by name. The Bible was gathered together into a single text 300 years before Muhammad existed, and the individual books of the Bible were written hundreds and thousands of years before that. So to cut to the heart of the matter, the Bible does not ever specifically mention the Quran or Muhammad. But that is not the end of the topic. The Bible, and therefore Christianity, does not teach about a prophet to follow Jesus. In fact, when Jesus was teaching, he taught a parable that the Son would be the last messenger. Matthew 21:33. Hear another parable. There was a certain householder which planted a vineyard, and hedged it round about, and digged a winepress in it, and built a tower, and let it out to husbandmen, and went into a far country. And when the time of the fruit drew near, he sent his servants to the husbandmen, that they might receive the fruits of it. And the husbandman took his servants, and beat one, and killed another, and stoned another. Again he sent other servants, more than the first, and they did unto them likewise. But last of all he sent unto them his son, saying, They will reverence my son. But when the husbandmen saw the son, they said among themselves, This is the heir. Come, let us kill him, and let us seize on his inheritance. And they caught him, and cast him out of the vineyard, and slew him. When the Lord therefore of the vineyard cometh, what will he do unto those husbandmen? They said unto him, He will miserably destroy those wicked men, and he will let out his vineyard into other husbandmen, which shall render him the fruits in their seasons. Jesus said unto them, Did you never read in the Scriptures, The stone which the builders rejected, the same is become the head of the corner. Therefore say I unto you, the kingdom of God shall be taken from you, and given to a nation bringing forth the fruits thereof. And whosoever shall fall on this stone shall be broken, but on whomsoever it shall fall, it will grind him to powder. And when the chief priests and Pharisees had heard his parable, they perceived that he spake of them. Notice, the Pharisees perceived Jesus was talking about them. This parable was about Jesus, Israel, and the Pharisees. Let's look again at the parable with that knowledge. Hear another parable. There was a certain householder which planted a vineyard, and hedged it round about, and digged a winepress in it, and built a tower, and let it out to husbandmen, and went into a far country. The vineyard owner is God. the garden is Israel. And when the time of the fruit drew near, he sent his servants to the husbandmen, that they might receive the fruits of it. And the husbandmen took the servants, and beat one, and killed another, and stoned another. The servants were the prophets that God sent. Some of the prophets were beaten, and stoned, and some were killed. Again he sent other servants, more than the first, and they did unto them likewise. But last of all he sent unto them his son, saying, They will reverence my son. God sees the Jews are not respecting the prophets. God says, last of all, they will respect my son. Jesus is teaching he is the Son of God. This is a core part of this parable. But when the husbandmen saw the son, they said among themselves, This is the heir, let us kill him, and let us seize on his inheritance. And they caught him, and cast him out of the vineyard, and slew him. Notice, this is the Son of God. They plan to kill the Son, the last one who could be sent to them. Then Jesus was killed on the cross by them. Jesus saith unto them, Did you never read in the Scriptures, The stone which the builders rejected, the same is become the head of the corner? Jesus is the stone that is being talked about here. The builders who reject the stone are the Jewish leaders, the Pharisees. And the stone the builders reject, Jesus, Yeshua, becomes the cornerstone. Therefore say I unto you, the kingdom of God shall be taken from you and given to a nation bringing forth the fruits thereof. Islam loves to misapply this verse. And given to a nation bringing forth the fruits thereof. Islam tries to claim this is the Arabs and Islam, the descendants of Ishmael. But again, the stone is Jesus. Whoever shall fall on this stone shall be broken. The nation spoken of is the Gentiles, and this means Christianity. But Yeshua, Jesus, he is the cornerstone. He is the center of everything. You see, from the Christian perspective, Yeshua is already the last and final messenger. Jesus taught that he was the last. So to ask us to consider Mohammed was a later messenger is to ask us to disbelieve Jesus, the Son of God, and call Jesus a liar. O Muslims, you say you believe Isa was a prophet, but you ignore his words. O Muslims, you do not even bother to learn what Isa said. Jesus taught he was the last to be sent. The passage I just read to you is clear, my friends. The Son was the highest messenger God could send. Christianity does not and never will respect Muhammad as a prophet from God. And that is only one reason of many I will share with you. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to his Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.